Thank you. Thank you very much. And welcome to Cats and Dogs here on Press TV with me, Len Potopic. And this week, we talk about something that happened once upon a time in Mexico. In fact, it's not once upon a time, it's now. You know the king of Pulp Fiction, Quentin Tarantino? Well, apparently his jaw dropped as he realized that some scenes of his films were being reconstructed for real at the US-Mexico border with no investment, no producers, no special effects, just all live and raw. Action! The reason Tarantino was so amazed is because a bunch of self-styled, saddled-up desperados did all this high chaparral stuff for a fraction the cost of one single Tarantino film. Yes, and about 14,000 Haitians who'd fled from poverty and political chaos to seek safe haven in the US were welcomed by these extras from some budget spaghetti western for free and violently, as those good old cowboys on horses showed them what the Wild West was really all about. On that point, have you ever noticed that Americans do not live in the present? The Democrats and their pseudo-progressive sympathizers are all trying to look ahead of their time. They make speeches about conquering Mars and living in some super green US universe. On the other hand, the Republicans and their conservative followers are all stuck in the past. They still talk about the days when the Deep South had it all right, you know, on those old cotton picking plantations all along the Mississippi River. So they'll like these cowboys, the same horses, whips, and social setup, just like they did before the abolition of slavery. But I digress. Now, some say that the cowboy police officers deserve medals because they defended the country against these illegal aliens. It's happened before. Remember when an American warship shot down Iran Air Flight 655 over the Persian Gulf, killing 290 passengers? What was the result? The commander who had ordered the shooting down of the airplane was awarded a medal. Now imagine if the Iranians had done that just next to JFK Airport in New York. Washington would have gone mental. Because it seems the only people who are allowed to blow up civil airliners out of the sky are the Americans. Actually, I feel really sorry for the Haitians. They live in some kind of weird reality TV show. First, they have to escape living in poverty under an incompetent government. Then they have to go through all kinds of tough challenges, like earthquakes, floods, and the ever-popular drowning scenario. After that, there's a bit of gymnastics over the Trump wall, followed by a wacky face-off with those American horsemen at the border. After that, it's time for a bit of harassment from the US police. And if they survive all this, what do they win? Well, in America, they get to live in poverty again, under an incompetent government again, just like Haiti. So, it's just the same, really, except that the weather's worse. In fact, the only ethnic resident of America who does get invited to go into a big white house by the state without having to clean it is the vice president. And even she only gets to go in to see a white man.
There's not a black man I know, be he a relative, a friend, or a coworker, who has not been the subject of some form of profiling or discrimination. Growing up, my sister and I had to deal with the neighbor who told us her parents couldn't play with us because we were black. But I also believe, and it's personal, and it was hurtful to hear you talk about the reputations of two United States senators who built their reputations and career on the segregation of race in this country. And it was not only that, but you also worked with them to oppose busing. And, you know, there was a little girl in California who was part of the second class to integrate her public schools. And she was bused to school every day. And that little girl was me.
Unfortunately, A lot of the Haitian migrants saw Kamala Harris on TV and thought that everyone with an ethnic background in America was treated like her. But while she's busy trying to keep Joe Biden awake in the Oval Office, our Haitian friends are busy reliving those scenes from Tarantino's best films.
Can't see shit out of this.
He's getting away.
Okay.
Big Daddy's getting away.
It's nuts. In fact, it's so nuts that in a rare display of unity, both Democrats and Republicans are said to be putting Sleepy Joe under pressure to wake up and recall the posse, which I think is not fair. Biden's just fulfilling his promise to create more jobs. And with all that Wild West stuff there, there's a tourist angle too. What's not to like? You could sell tickets, and the Haitians will obviously appear in these shows for free. It's a job creation scheme because the cowboys get to ride and attack the Haitians, pilots get to fly the Haitians back to home, and Joe Biden can have a job as the on-set advisor for the parts with the horses because he's the only American old enough to remember what it was like 200 years ago. After the Haitians gathered at the US-Mexican border, the Biden administration declared a state of emergency. That's a rare thing. A state of emergency only really happens when the Japanese attack Pearl Harbor or when the president misunderstands something. What time is it?
Mr. President, it's Monday morning.
Did you just say the Mexicans are coming? I declare a state of emergency.
And why are the Americans so afraid of migrants anyway? After all, if you go back far enough, if all the immigrant families had to leave, the population of the UK and Ireland would become about 400 million. And the American Indians would have North America all to themselves. But no, instead, migrants are portrayed as the cause of all Americans' problems.
What demagoguery is about is scapegoating minorities who have no power, who are saying to people who have lost their jobs or are working longer hours for low wages, it is the Muslims who are responsible for you losing your jobs or working for low wages. It is Latinos in the United States who are responsible. The antidote to that is to create a powerful movement of working class people who have the guts not to scapegoat minorities, but have the guts to take on the billionaire class that we should be talking about.
Let's get some truth here. To find out more about what's really going on, we decided to reach out to the former US Special Envoy to Haiti, who recently quit over the deportation of Haitian migrants. Ladies and gentlemen, exclusively here on Cats and Dogs, please welcome Mr. Daniel Foote. Sir, welcome to Cats and Dogs. What exactly did you do as a U.S. Special Envoy to Haiti?
Well, I was supposed to tell Mr. President when the Haitians were traveling to the U.S. so the president could be on the border to declare a state of emergency. Oh, sorry, I have got to go.
Sir, you've only just come on the show.
Hi there. This is Vice President Harris.
Kamala Harris? What an honor. Well, what's your plan for the migrant crisis?
My plan is to turn that crisis into my 2024 presidential campaign.
Hold on. So you think you can become the president with their votes?
Well, I could win if Sleepy Joe would just let them come in.
Oh, why won't he? I thought he was wanting to make friends with the world again.
Ask him yourself. Hey, Joe, wake up.
President Biden?
Who is this?
I'm Len Bitopic.
Is that a Haitian name? Get out.
No, I'm not Haitian, and I'm not in America.
I stand squarely behind my decision.
Which decision?
Our withdrawal from Iraq was a historic moment.
What are you talking about?
I mean, we don't have even one single soldier in Vietnam, and you can quote me
but
on
what
that.
About the migrants? Well, that was weird. Now let's take a look at some pictures coming from the border. In this picture, Haitians are being saved from drowning by some good Samaritans. Meanwhile, here we see an American do-gooder trying to give the Haitian a lift home. But his eagerness to help clearly annoys the Haitian. And this is a Waterwell Fun Park built specially by the federal government to welcome migrants while they wait for their migration paperwork to be done, which can sometimes take as little as 10 years. Now it's that time to see who's the good, who's the bad, and who's the ugly this week. This week is, without doubt, Joe Biden. He's innocent of all wrongdoing over this Haitian affair because he was asleep during the whole episode. The bad this week is the Haitian earthquake. It shook the ground so hard that when it stopped, some of the local population had landed in America, apparently. And the ugly this week is Donald Trump, who said the US is becoming a cesspool of humanity under Biden. But in an uncertain world, it's good to know that some people never change. That's all for this week. Join me again next time to find out if Biden mixes up his State of the Nation speech with the state of emergency, if Quentin Tarantino can never make a Western as unbelievable as those cowboys on the Mexican border, and if Vice President Kamala Harris gets mistaken for a White House cleaner. That's all on Press TV with me, Lembitopic, and cats and dogs.